Now let's talk about technique. This particular technique is for overcoming the problem of external fragmentation into variable size partitioning or dynamic size partitioning. So in the dynamic size partitioning that we have seen in the last lecture is talking about the accommodation of the process into the memory without any fixed size. It is of variable size. But the thing is that the internal fragmentation is free in the dynamic size partitioning or variable size partitioning, but the external fragmentation is still here. So how we can overcome the external fragmentation? So the answer is compaction. So there is a compaction method by which we can do that. Let's see. We got to know that the dynamic partitioning suffer from external fragmentation. Just now we have seen. However, this can cause some serious problem. To avoid compaction, we need to change the rule, which says that the process cannot be stored in a different place in the memory. So either we have to go for the non-contiguous memory allocation. We can also use compaction to minimize the probability of external fragmentation. So what it says that the external fragmentation problem could be solved if we have non-contiguous memory allocation. But now we are talking about contiguous memory allocation. In that, there is a solution called compaction. So what happened in the compaction? It is to minimize the probability of external fragmentation in compaction. All the free partition are made contiguously and all the loaded partition is brought together. So what we do is we made a compaction. Let's say we have that scenario. Let's assume that there is operating system. And in some partition, we have accommodated. Another partition is free. This partition is again accommodated. So let's say this is of 2 MB, this is of 2 MB, this is of 3 MB, this is of, let's say, 4 MB. Now, after the compaction, my memory will look like this. There is operating system. There is the loaded part. This is of 2 MB. This is again a loaded part of with the process. This is of 3 MB. And then this free space is of 6 MB. Are you getting how this 6 MB came? From this 2 MB and from this 4 MB. So I get the contiguous memory allocation after the compaction. By applying this technique, we can store the bigger processes in the memory. The free partition are merged with which can now be allocated according to the need of the new process. This technique is also called defragmentation. So you might have learned this defragmentation in the various operating system, including Windows. You will find this defragmentation technique, where you can defragment the storage into the disk. The same we can apply here in the main memory also with the help of compaction. So in this particular figure, as you can see in the previous example, where the memory is 5 MB and 3 MB in a scattered way or in the fragmented way, will be compacted here in the 5 MB and 3 MB. And this will become 8 MB, and we can accommodate this process P5 here in this particular 8 MB memory allocation. Getting it? That is called compaction. So here P5 can be loaded into the memory because the free space is now made contiguous by compaction method, which could not be loaded into the memory due to the lack of the contiguous space, can be loaded now in the memory space since the free partition are made contiguous with the help of compaction process. Now let's talk about the problem with the compaction. The efficiency of the system is declared in the case of compaction due to the fact that all the free spaces will be transferred into several places in a single space. Why it is taken as a efficiency to increasing the efficiency of the system, so that if we are compacting, means the free spaces will be allocated into one chunk of memory, and we are creating a chunk of memory which can accommodate the further processes, so we can increase the degree of multiprogramming in that way. That is the objective, right? How we can increase the degree of multiprogramming so that the resources will be utilized as much as possible and throughput could be increased. Now here the problem is the huge amount of time is invested for this process. The CPU will remain idle for all the time, despite of the fact that the compaction avoid external fragmentation. It makes system inefficient because it is taking a lot of time to bake a chunk of memory from occupied or non-occupied way. It is taking a lot of time. Let's consider one example. Let's say in the operating system needs 6 nanoseconds to copy one byte from one place to another. If one byte, it is taking 6 nanoseconds. So 256 MB transmission, how much it will take? 256 into 2 to the power of 20, because it is of MB, into 6 nanosecond, it is 10 to the power of minus 9 seconds. So these much of time we have to give for the 256 MB of RAM. So you can see how much time we are giving in compaction. Hence, it is proved to some extent that the large size memory transfer needs some huge amount of time, that is in second. That's why this compaction process is not very popular process to resolve the external fragmentation issue in variable size partition.